to introduce. Then, of course, we have
Although Murang'a Governor Mwangi Wa Iria was physically present during the hearings before the Special Committee of the Senate chaired by David Musila, it was his lawyer Ng'ang'a Mbugua who rose to defend the embattled leader. Wa Iria wanted the committee to declare the impeachment process unprocedural, claiming the county assembly did not accord him a fair hearing as required by the law.
The assembly moved, and this is a factual statement, moved the motion before even the expiry of the 7 days that the speaker, so that if the intention of the assembly was to wait for the expiry of 7 days, you actually moved the motion on the 21st, before the expiry of the 7 days.
Wa Iria questioned the motive behind his impeachment. He claimed the plot to remove him from office was hatched after he refused to grant MCA's demands for a ward development fund. Each MCA was demanding 20 million shillings, demands that would have cost the county millions at the expense of development.
There is, number one, no nexus between the purported allegation and the person of the governor.
The county assembly's legal counsel, Mbudhi Gedenji, read out 25 accusations leveled against Wa Iria, among them abuse of office and gross violation of the constitution, mostly relating to mismanagement of public funds. Wa Iria is also accused of high-handedness and making unilateral decisions.
Would you say your governor has gone out of his way to attempt to engage with the county assemblies in the light of these issues in the last 1 month or so when these issues came up?
The assembly has sent businessmen, religious leaders, eminent persons to the governor to tone down his handwriting stance only for them to hate their dead. These noble efforts have become a nullity as the governor continues to burn all the bridges and isolate himself by building a high wall between him and the people.
The councils were allowed to cross-examine witnesses as Senate gathered information that could go into its final report. The special committee is required to report back to the plenary after 10 days with a report that will either substantiate or dismiss the allegations against Governor Wa Iria. Ken Dagor, Obadia Citizen, Business Center.